Hi everyone! Welcome to my channel, I'm Sal. Yes, I'm wearing all black because there's some mysterious forces out there. No, seriously, I'm kidding! Come on guys, it's the full moon where everything is just out in the open. I'm not trying to be mystic with you guys. It's just astrology, I mean not just astrology, but it's the moon. It's the face of the moon, right? And this is something that's happening that will not happen until 18, 19, 20 years, something like that, right? So this is the full moon in Pisces, which is about, which is ruled by Neptune. So I'm using a tarot of the dreams, which is Neptune is about, illusions, right? And we're doing also major arcana for all cards. The first thing that they will, hold on, I'm getting too high. First, we're doing the major arcana for each sign that is being affected. Then we have palaces. Which house it's affecting? Cups, swords, and other, whatever the other two, the ones, right? And we're gonna have the oracle of the rebel, because I feel that we all are rebels because sometimes we just don't want to follow, right? Because it's more fun. Not unless you're a Virgo, then it means you just have to follow. I don't think a Virgo would watch this, right? We're all fire signs here. Not unless you're cross watching. Shh. Okay. Let's do this. So Aries, Leo, Sag. And I do love Virgos, okay? Just letting you guys know, okay? It's the first sign that caught my breath away, okay? That's what I'm saying. First, Aries, Leo, and Sag. Oh, we go in that order. Aries, this is what you're having. Oh, this is the chariot, okay? Leo, we have here the world. Oh no, sorry, Wheel of Fortune. And, ooh, Sag. I forgot what this is. But I'll figure it out. Because this is a new card. And there's no, I'm gonna feel it. Zero. Is it the sun? No, it's not the sun. The Fool! There. Okay, let's see what houses it affects. I don't know, the houses will be later when I do the reading. I'm gonna get the supplementary arcana. Okay, so yeah, so I'm using the quantum tarot for that, and I literally just opened it right now, so I'm not familiar because I wanted myself to be surprised also. Oh my golly, Leo, how come they have the Fool and you have the Hangman or whatever? Okay, first we're doing the Aries. We have the chariot and faith over here, and we're gonna see what house it gets affected, and then we'll see the energy. And I'm gonna tell you guys where it affects or how this affects your sign or your, you know, whoever's watching this. Okay, first, okay. Oh, I did it wrong. It's okay. There's no wrong. This is what's meant. Because there's supposed to be one central card. I choose three central cards. This is gonna be just a special for the fire sign. Okay, so you have here the chariot, okay? The energy that you're facing towards right now, once this cycle starts, the full moon, okay? I'm not sure how far it was gonna go, but this is a major energy. That's why it went only major arcana. It's charging. Now, which is funny, is like you're charging towards where? Or where do you need change in your life that you need to push? Palace of Coins, your money. Okay, this is a major thing that you need to face, and normally things happen in the full moon where everything arises. So you need to address that issue, because if you don't, it will cripple you down and it will again happen. Again, that's karma, logic. Okay, you have here faith. Okay, so it's asking you to have trust and you know that whatever you're doing, whatever your goals, your dreams, go towards that part because it will address your House of Coins. Okay? That is what's happening major. At least it's not a heartbreak. We can all use a little bit of a, you know, an easy on that part. We're doing like love reading crazy. Leo, let me see what house you're affected. Okay. Okay, let's see. Oh, Wands. Okay, your passion, whatever you want to study. I feel that this is about you. Okay. So you have here the world. Okay. Oh, sorry, Wheel of Fortune. So you're manifesting something. Not that you're manifesting. Whatever you are doing,
Okay? It is closely related to your, it's not cups, it's not your emotion, it's your passion. Very interesting. And you're waiting for this to happen. This is the Hangman, right? So if you are waiting for something to happen and you have the world, it means it's meeting of time, meeting of karma. You waited and you got Wheel of Fortune. So it connects. And whatever you're working on, for example, now, right? It's the House of Wands that you are facing. This is what is close to your heart. Whatever is close to your heart. It can be, you know, your love life. It's fine. You can do that. But whatever is always close to your heart. It can be your hobby, you know, things that you do. You like to travel. You like to study. All these things is manifesting, or that's the thing that you need to focus on in this transit. Okay, so very, very important. Focus on your passion. And it will align. Sagittarius. Okay, let's see what you guys have. Which house? Ta-da! Palace of Coins. And you got the world. Yay! We have here the Fool. Sagittarius, main focus. Take a chance. Don't think. Act. What's supplementary? The world. Don't you just love this kind of reading? Like, it's just raining and blessings. But this is the dreams, okay? Again, I'm showing what Neptune and illusions are being revealed to you. You're always focused here on Earth, okay? That's what we do. We're focused, right? And then we forgot about our dreams or what is out there. And this is what's out there. Take a chance on whatever you feel like taking a chance, okay? I'm not asking you to jump off a building, Sag. People will die. And you will die. It's asking you to manifest something strongly connected to something that you are believing in, okay? So, you have here all these elements around the world, okay? The world card, okay? All this basically are in your control, are in your in reach, so that you can manage, okay? So even though you take that leap of faith and nothing on the ground, expect that all this karma will come back to you. All the good karma will come back, okay? So you won't land on the dead floor, like, you know, not at all. And which house that you need to take a chance on? Palace of Coins. Meaning, if you have something strong in your career, in your money, in your finances, that you feel strongly that you need to work on, and you have a focus on it, go do it. There is no doubt that that is the energy that you need to work on. I'm not saying you're not gonna fail. That is bullcrap. You will fail if you're stupid. But it's asking you to take a chance. Again, don't be stupid. Okay. That's gonna be your full moon reading for Feb 26. Now, it's not for a particular day. This is a culminating energy that you need to work on, okay, as it transits, so that you can manifest more closely related to what Neptune or Pisces in a full moon in Pisces, that energy that you can use, so that you can really, really make that connection with that certain transit. Okay, again, I'm not a ninja, but I always do this. Thank you guys. I'll see you guys again next time, the next full moon. Bye.